to you, yeah. And Lord, let me burn for you again. Let me return to you again. God, I'm running for your heart. I'm running for your heart to light up my soul.
Amen, amen. This is yours truly, Evangelist Willie Grizzle from the House of Prayer Radio Ministries. I hope today that you're enjoying the snow. Amen, praise God. I hope today that you are putting your suit of armor on for Jesus Christ. Amen, that dealing with all matters, if it's about happiness, sadness, death. You know, brothers and sisters, as a body of Christ, we both unite each other with Jesus Christ. Amen. When we see a brother or sister that's hurting, that's had a lost one, loved one, amen, that we both unite together and pray for one another and comfort each other with the word. Amen. So I've had a brother, Boyd London, on my mind. I was reading early this morning that his uncle had passed away. And I asked you all to be praying for his uncle that is gone to be away with the Father. You know, it says in the scriptures very clearly that away from the body is to be with the Lord. You know, the body must go into the ground, go back to where it came from. Praise God. And we need, but in the human side of us, amen, the flesh, we hate to see him go. But you know, Jesus Christ has a plan for everyone. We are all dedicated to go back to the earth unless we get raptured home. Amen. Amen. I'm not talking about poof gone. I mean, when it's time for all of God's body, God's children to go, we'll all go at the same time. But you know, somebody gets raptured out of this world every second of every day. Amen. So brothers and sisters, let's remember Brother Boyd. Let's remember, all the ones that are in the shut-in sick today. Let's remember all the people that needs God in their life. Amen. You know, today's Sunday. I couldn't be able to go to church today because my truck's about under 2 foot of snow. Amen. Try to get out and went down in the ditch. Amen. Praise God. Just keep me in prayer that be able to get it out tomorrow because I could go to work tomorrow. Or might be footing it. Amen. Praise God. It's a long walk. Well, when we might just have to pray about that. Amen. Praise God. So, hello, Brother Chris in the chat room. God bless you, brother. How you doing? I hope that you're doing fine. If you don't mind, on your friends list, can you please share the service and tell them that we're talking about how to deal with death. Amen. You know, death comes upon each other's door. Somebody, and I don't know about you, but somebody in their life has died. Amen. That's passed away. They'll be with the Father. Amen. But, you know, the question is, how were they before they left? Amen. Was they growing a harvest for Jesus Christ, or was they living for their own? Amen. See, there's a lot of people don't understand that. Well, I always hear this comment, it says, only God knows. Amen. But God shows us through the Spirit, praise God, that what we are both to be doing and how we both to live our life. Amen. Praise God. And we both to be in the will of the Father. Amen. That's like the song says, must be on fire for God. Amen. Like it says over in Exodus, Ezekiel 12:7, thou shalt dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it. Amen. See, God gives life. Just think about all these little babies that are born now, amen? And when you was born, amen? See, God gave life onto you. But, you know, He gave you a short period of time, praise God, to make it right with him. Praise God that you would stand strong and be true to him and to his work and his love, his mercy. And when you see a brother or sister's down, that death has knocked on their friends or family's door, you got to go and be able to comfort them. Amen. Praise God. So many people will come to a funeral home. Amen. And pay their last respects. But you know, sometimes I wonder how many times did they pay respect while they were alive? I mean, now come on, let's get serious here. You know, a lot of people will say, well, I've known them for 20 years, but makes you think in the back of your mind, well, in them 20 years, how many times did you break bread with them? How many times did you speak the Lord, thou God, upon their heart, their mind? How many times did you open the Bible and read a word of God to them? Amen. See, brothers and sisters, when you get ready for death, there's only thing God's going to be looking for is himself in you. See, brothers and sisters, today is a day of salvation. You haven't got time to be playing silly games. You ain't got time to be catching what's the latest and greatest on TV. See, salvation come with a cost, amen? And that's the blood of Jesus Christ. And if you're not washed in that blood of Jesus Christ, you're not going to heaven, amen? See, brothers and sisters, the true facts is today, if you're not serving God, you're serving the world. And this world will eat you up. If you're not a separated person, like it says in the word, separated from this world. And we must be particular people, amen? We need to step out with our suit and fight the evil spirits. Not a man, because man is not the problem. We fight against principalities in the darkness of the air. Amen? See, brothers and sisters, we need to stand up and proclaim the word of God. Hello, Brother Greg. God bless you. Brother, how we doing? I hope that you're doing good. I hope you're staying warm. I am. Amen. I ain't got much other choice. I got 2 foot of snow out here outside the minister door here. And if I had to go get something, I got to walk. I know. It's a good way to get exercise. Yeah, I know. I'm getting old and arthritis ain't the greatest on me. Amen. But, you know, God let me wake up and he let me serve him one more day. Amen. Praise God. And, Brother Greg, since you just tuned in, remember, warm and toasty. Amen. Let's remember Brother Boyd. I don't know if you caught across Facebook that his uncle had passed away and, he gone to be with the Lord. Amen. So let's keep that family in prayer. Let's unite together and pray. Amen. That, it seems like a Brother Boyd's got a lot of death coming in the family. But, you know, God is good. There's a purpose for all things. Amen. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, let's listen to testimony from Brother Boyd.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. I've been calling in numerous calls today over to the Saving America One Soul at a Timeline, Gospel Music Jukebox Line, calling in scripture after scripture and preaching, trying to motivate people to become true disciples of Jesus, who have some action to their faith, who actually go out there and do something for Jesus in this lost and dying world. So many people we ask, you want to pray for people? No. I want to share testimonies? No. I want to help orphans, widows, and needy people, people in the prisons and hospitals? No. I want to go witness someone like Dusty Moyers, who was in gangs and on drugs, long hair and a beard. Get him saved. Tell him the good news of Jesus. No, it wouldn't even let him in the churches because he was a mess. I believe we need to make some changes in our life. I see Brother Bishop Eddie Cheney over on his Facebook page just posted something on there that we got to be helping the needy. We got to be denying ourselves from Luke 9:23-26, taking up our cross and losing our life for Jesus and the gospel. We got to have some action to our faith. I just posted this over on my Facebook page in our group. This is something I wrote. We should ask ourselves what the death and resurrection of Jesus means to us. We're saved by grace, but Jesus Christ calls his followers to crucify sin, saying no to ungodliness, to go out and do good works, helping people. He wants us helping poor and needy people and brothers and sisters. He wants us to go heal people, become disciples and Christians. He wants us, each of us, to preach the gospel to the world, to anyone we need to come across. He expects us to deny ourselves daily and live for him and for his purposes. So we are his followers. His love for us and his death and resurrection for us should motivate us to love him and to live like this daily for our Lord and Savior. helping other people. It's something we can all work on each day, learning how to love and help others. Brother Willie, I just don't know if this John 3:16 believe in Jesus stuff's going to cut it when they stand before Jesus on Judgment Day. Luke 9:20 or 22-26 tells us to deny ourselves and lose our life for the gospel. Matthew chapter 7 tells us many are going to say, Lord, Lord, but not have done the will of God. Now, Father, it says they're not going to put Jesus' words into practice. They're not going to have been doers of the word, and they're going to be called workers of iniquity, cast out and told by Jesus that he never knew them. So all these people that don't want to do anything for Jesus or the gospel, that have homosexuality and sin and pornography in their life and don't truly repent, but they're saying they believe in Jesus, go to church on Sundays, and they're going to heaven. They don't do anything else for Jesus except going to church on Sundays. They may be called workers of iniquity and cast out, even though they think that they're saved. I am called to be a watchman from the book of Ezekiel, and I am warning people right now that if you're not a doer of the word, if you don't deny yourself for Jesus and the gospel, if you don't have some action into your faith, you may be called a worker of iniquity and cast out. God is a righteous and good judge, but I guess everyone's going to find out what happens when we stand before him on Judgment Day, and everyone will stand before God and be judged. And I have many scriptures on this post over here also. Jesus calls us to take up our cross and deny ourselves daily, Luke 9:23-26. Let's deny ourselves for Jesus and be doers of the word. God bless all. Amen.
Amen. Amen. What a word. Amen. Praise God. You know, like it says over here in Romans 14:8, he says, for whether we live unto the Lord. Whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live through, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. See, now, brothers and sisters, that's why Lord had me to have a talk about today about death. You know, it seems like a lot of preachers are skipping around this. They don't want to talk death because they says, well, we just need to talk about life. Well, let me tell you something. If you want to give life to someone, let it be the life of the Lord. Amen. The word of God. Because we need to warn them and tell them. I says, now, brother, if you're not right with God, or sister, you're not right with God, the consequences of your sin is death, eternity, torment, suffering. See, I don't want to see no man go to hell, or woman, child, anybody. But I'll tell you this much. If your name is not in that book of life, and you leave this earth, I mean, when you die, when you pass away, and you face judgment, if he does not know you, he's not going to let you be a guest in heaven. There's only one other place you'll go, and that's hell. That's where you'll be in eternity, in flames, and suffering, and pain, and misery. And you can't repent after you're dead. Don't believe me, read about the story about Lazarus and the king. Amen. You know, a king, he had all the finer things of the world. He didn't think he needed God. He didn't think he needed a personal walk with Jesus. Well, Lazarus sat around at his door, and he had sores all over him. The dogs was tearing, licking his sores. And all he wanted was just a crumb from the king's table. Well, he died. And he went to Abraham's bosom. Well, the king died too. Amen. And he ended up in torment for eternity. See now, brothers and sisters, you have a choice in this life today. You can serve God and live for God and die for God. Or you can live for yourself, or Satan, or this world, and bust hell wide open. The truth is, brothers and sisters, my brothers and sisters, even me, I'm guilty of this too. I'm stepping on my own toes, that we need to be doing more for Christ. Amen? We need to get out beside of our comfort zone. Amen? And get up and stand in the battle for the Lord Jesus Christ. See, brothers and sisters, we both be a soldier for the Lord. We ain't both to be preaching just to the congregation or the saints. Amen. We both to get out in the battlefield. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, let me ask you something. Are you a soldier?
I'm a soldier in the army soldier in the army. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier in the army. I'm a soldier.
God, are you a soldier? Amen. I hope you are, because, brothers and sisters, the battle is getting stronger every day. Praise God. Satan, amen, that old slew-foot devil, he wants to tear you down, brothers and sisters. He wants you to come to his side. He wants you to think everything's just old fine and dandy. Now, let me tell you something. The devil rides on a idle horse. That's something my grandpa used to tell me all the time. He said, son, when you think everything's good and everything's swell and dandy, that's when the devil is ready to deceive you. See, you got to be prepared like a soldier, amen? You got to have the word. That's your gun, amen? That 66 cannon, amen? That when the devil comes at you, you can blast him back with the word of God. Praise God. And you got to be suited up, amen? You got to, when you go into battle, you just don't go running through her naked, amen? You got to have the blessings, the power, the glory, and all the word of God upon your life, on your body, and in your heart, and in your mind. See, the devil plays in your mind. He'll make you think, well, this is fine, and a little of this will be all right, a little bit of that will be all right. But let me tell you something. A little bit can cause you to miss heaven. Amen. You know, I know a lot of my friends today that, you know, tax season's coming up, and we were talking about that, about income taxes, and what they was going to tell their tax officials that how to get more money. Well, let me tell you something. If you lie to people to get more money from the government, you have committed sin. That's right. See, God provides for all his people. Amen. That that we will stand and proclaim the word of God. But if we don't live it in our own life, see, you're holding your own candle. Praise God. God's giving you a candle. Now, the question is, are you going to let it shine, or are you just going to let it shine when it's convenient? Praise God. So many people today has lost their shine and their candle. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, let me ask you a question. Can a white lie keep you from going to heaven? Good question. Anybody got any scripture that they would like to post up? Praise God. Let's help each other out. You know, you never know. Somebody sows in the balance. Amen. Somebody today is making a decision if they want to get drunk on a snowy day because, well, I can't get no worse. I'll just get plastered. Let me tell you something. That ain't helping your soul or your body either. Amen. See, brothers and sisters, we need to get up and proclaim the word of God. Let me ask you something. Have you went out and talked to your neighbors today on this cold, snowy day? Have you checked on your neighbors, your family, and your friends? See if they've been all right? Is everybody taken care of? Or you just want to sit back in front of the heater? Don't worry. I'm stepping on my own toes, too. See, I didn't want to get out this morning, but the Lord, he put it on my heart to go check on some neighbors. And I had to walk uptown to get some groceries for them, and I took care of that, praise God. But, you know, one thing we all got to understand, if we do something, this is something my daddy always told me. You see, now, you've heard me talk about my dad. My dad, he wasn't the greatest guy before he got saved, amen. But he always told me, he says, don't do something in the daylight that you can't lay down at night with. Amen. So when I do what God had me to do, I sleep like a baby. Amen. But if I do something wrong, I can't sleep with it. I'll toss and turn, and it just drives me nuts. Amen. But you know, brothers and sisters, that's where that Holy Spirit's working upon you, telling that you have done an error. That's where you need to get it correct with God. And whatever God tells you to do, you do what God tells you to do. Amen. See, a lot of people like to give instructions. Amen. Likes to tell what people how to live their life, how to serve God. See, we all have a different way to serve God. My way is preaching the gospel and helping one another where God had me to help. But you could be a singer, amen, and a song might give somebody some peace in a time of grieving, amen. Or if you might be a carpenter, amen, and somebody needs a porch built or needs a ramp put up on their house that's in a wheelchair. See, God uses all his soldiers. It ain't always in defense. Sometimes it's offense to help people guide their way to God. Amen. See, now, a lot of people won't take time to search out the scripture, what God have them to do. But you know, one day, them scriptures that you remembered, that you live by, will be answered for. Amen. It's like it says over here in Luke 23:43. And Jesus said unto him, Very, very, I say unto thee, thou shalt thou be with me in paradise. See, now, if you continue in this war that we're having on this earth with the devil, and life comes to an end, guess what? You're on your way to paradise. But if you're just picking your fights, amen, that's what a lot of church buildings, let me get that clear, church buildings are doing today. They're picking their fights. They only preach about what they won't offend too many people. Let me tell you something, brothers and sisters, if you don't use from the beginning to the end of the word of God, you will be judged upon that. Now remember, see, a lot of people talk about just the book of life. Well, there's another book going to be open. It's called a book of deeds. Amen. Good or bad, you'll have to answer for. Let me tell you, you ain't going to be like Adam, go hide under a bushel somewhere to hide away from God. See, you're going to be in the presence of a mighty and just God. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, let's listen to another testimony from Brother Boyd.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd, London, Idaho. I've got a pretty busy weekend here. We got more snowstorms and stuff. We got some disabled people to take care of, so I won't be able to be on Facebook too much until Monday. But I'll be praying for everyone, making some calls in when I can. We're having a big battle over on Facebook. I've got some people who are gay mad at me over there. They tried to hack one of our big groups last night, and they don't like me calling in and preaching against that on the programs. I made some calls on the programs and spoke out against homosexuality last night, that it's a sin, and they don't like that. We've had them before take over groups and start posting God loves gay stuff and everything in there, and I've got people, they're trying to report me to Facebook and say a bunch of bad things, so if you see that, just ignore it. They're trying to get me my account shut off. If that happens, then I'll just try to set up another account. But, you know, being into homosexuality is a sin. It's an abomination to God, it says. There's many strictures of our life. I just found out last night that two of my friends who are into the ministry, preaching the Word of God, two more of my friends, I have other friends also, I found out one is bisexual and one is gay, and they're preaching the Word of God, saying they're going to heaven. But if we are called to be watchmen in the book of Ezekiel, and we have to warn that homosexuality is a sin, and it will send people to hell. We have to preach against it. So even if people hate us for it, and they do get upset, I can tell you they get very upset. Right now, I just want to read a couple of things. This is 2 Timothy 1:7. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. If you'll turn your heart and life over to God and Jesus, He'll give you not a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. And this is one of the things I've read before. Faith, love, doubt, and fear. Doubt and fear, the two tormenting twins of the enemy sent to torment you down here. Doubt and fear will rob you of faith and all spirituality too. Doubt and fear will dog your tracks as you walk down here. But doubt and fear do not belong to a child of God, for you see you're a child of the Father, a child of faith and love. Faith and love come down from the Father above. Faith and love to abide in your spirit and heart, for you to walk in love and act by faith. Steal not when the enemy shows his head, run away and hide, but rather you and the Word of God shall abide and speak forth by faith and love, and all of God's blessings shall be showered on you from above. And just remember to turn your heart and life over to God and Jesus. They will help you. You don't have to worry no matter what you're facing, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. Remember Philippians 4:13 says we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Jesus will strengthen us and help us get it through. Jesus will strengthen us and help us get through the trials and challenges and through the persecution. When we face persecution, remember, and if you haven't turned your life over to Jesus, He loves you. If you are caught up in the sin of homosexuality, you can turn your heart and life over to Jesus. Ask Him to help you repent, and Jesus can help you repent of that sin or any sin. Please turn your life over to Jesus and help Him let you repent. God bless all and have a good day. Amen.
Little old David met Goliath with no sword or shield, saying, "You don't know my God." Just like old Daniel up in the lion's den, saying, "You don't know my God. You don't know what He's done for me. You don't know how He set me free. And if you think that all hope is gone, then you don't know my God." In a cold, dark prison, old Paul and Silas sang, just like the Hebrew children in the fire that day, singing, "You don't know my God. You don't know what He's done for me. You don't know just how He set me free. And if you think
Amen. You don't know my God. Amen. Praise God. Brothers and sisters, today, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, how about you take this little time that when you're snowed in, amen, that you ain't got nowhere to go and you can't get out. Let's talk to mighty Jesus, amen. See, he is the one that brings you out of the darkness. He's the one that forgives you for your sins. Praise God. He's the one that brings light into your life where you're in depression or alcohol or using your body for sex. See, he's the one that went on that old rugged cross to die for your sin, that you would be free, free indeed. See, so many people in this world today will walk away from you when you're in a time of trouble or a time of death. But Jesus said he'd never leave you and he'd never forsake you. See, Jesus is closer than a friend could ever be. He's with you in the daylight. He's with you in the dark. He's with you when you're happy. He's with you when you're sad. He's with you when you're on top of that mountain praising his holy name, or in that valley when you're crying. Jesus is there. See, brothers and sisters, we're not here to execute nobody, but we're here to kill the sin that dwells within them. See, that's what it means to be a soldier, brothers and sisters. It's not to go running, gunning, and knocking everybody down for the way they believe. But sometimes we have to go correct them. Amen. Show them the Word of God. Give them the peace and the heart and the mind of their life. To show them that Jesus Christ is still alive. And he's sitting on the right hand of the throne of the great and mighty God. See, brothers and sisters, he wants you today to feel his glory, to feel his mercy. And I know, like Brother Boyd, is another loved one has passed and to gone be with the Lord. But Brother Boyd, if you're listening on the sideline, let me tell you something. God ain't forget you. He knows the battle you're going through. He was there the moment they happened. And this song I dedicate to Brother Boyd's family.
On an icy road one night, a young man loses his life. They mark the shoulder with a cross, and his family gathers round on a piece of hallowed ground. Their hearts are heavy with their loss. As the tears fall from their eyes, there's one who'll always sympathize. Sad when I think of my granddad, I miss him each and every day. But I know the time will come when my own grandson will wonder why I went away. maybe we're not meant to understand till we meet up in the promised land.
Brother and sister, we are so far from home because there's a mansion, amen, that's built for us in Glory Land that one day that we'll walk down that street of gold, amen. But you know, but as long as we live, we must continue on in the Word of God, amen. Like 1 Chronicles 15, 51 through 57 says, "Behold, I show you a mystery. You shall not all sleep, but you shall all be changed. In a moment, in a twinkle of an eye, at that last trumpet, the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall rise incorruptible, and will be changed. From the corrupted must be put on incorrupted. The mortal must be put on immortality. So when the corrupted shall have put on incorrupted, and the mortal shall put on mortality, they shall pass and say, right, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thou sting? O grave, where is thou victory? The sting of death is sin, and strength of sin is the law. But thank by the God that give us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." So brothers and sisters, don't worry about death. It must happen. But let me tell you something. On the other side is a place called the Glory Land, amen, that we all shall travel. Brothers and sisters, stay strong in the Lord. Remember, sinner will not go into heaven, but a saint that is true with God and fights that battle for the soldiers, amen, soldier of God. Remember, continue to pray for me as I pray for you. God bless you all. This is yours truly, Evangelist Willie Grizzle.
They say that you came and died for the lost, and one drop of your blood is all that I cost. The preacher says Jesus is all that I need to save an old sinner like me. But can you save an old sinner like me? Is your blood strong enough to set my troubled soul free? I don't know if my life can be changed or made right, just not good enough. I don't deserve to be loved. But in my heart there's a feeling that just won't let go, and a question that I need to know. Can you save an old sinner like me? Is your blood strong enough to set my troubled soul free? I don't know if my life can be changed or made right. Can you save an old sinner like me? Down on my knees, I'm taking a chance. I'm asking God, please, to forgive my past. And Lord, just one favor, will you grant me? Will you save an old sinner like me? Lord, you saved an old sinner like me. I know your blood's strong enough, it set my troubled soul free. Now with you in my life, I've been changed and made right. Cause you saved an old sinner.